Soldiers and Marines are given their vehicles and the bases that support those vehicles an electric facelift. What does that mean? Well, from new tech that uses more electricity and less gas to a net zero Marine base that meets electricity needs with alternative fuels, the Army and Marine Corps are making a lot of electrification moves. At the May Modern Day Marine Expo in Washington, D.C., experts over Marine Corps vehicle fleets and bases laid out initiatives at various bases to update and upgrade their electric vehicle charging capabilities and non-tactical vehicles. But vehicle electrification and smart energy for bases isn't really new. However, an executive order signed this past year by President Joe Biden added fuel to that electric fire, setting goals for ramping up electric vehicle operations and support for those systems. So far, Marine bases in California, Arizona, South Carolina, and Georgia have been the test beds for alternative fueling and improved electric vehicle charging and use. Officials with the Marine Corps Logistics Base in Albany, Georgia, announced in late May that the base was the first installation to achieve what the Defense Department calls net zero. Net zero means it produces as much electricity from renewable green energy sources as it consumes each year. For example, the base has two landfill gas generators that produce about 4 megawatts of power, a biomass steam turbine generator that puts out about 8.5 megawatts of energy. Those two projects alone cover most of the base's needs. The base typically consumes about 4 to 6 megawatts in the winter and another 8 to 11 megawatts over the summer months. In case that's not enough, officials noted that the base's 27 diesel backup generators can take over in a crisis by pumping out a combined 7 megawatts by themselves. On the tactical side, the Army recently announced an anti-idle switch as part of a larger tactical vehicle electrification kit on its joint light tactical vehicles. The anti-idle switch powers down a vehicle's engine's rumble as it's just sitting around, saving fuel and reducing refueling stops and also giving silent mode for combat operations, both strategic and tactical pluses. Reducing noise, reducing signature, all help avoid detection on the battlefield. The anti-idle switch by itself saves about 17% more fuel during a standard operations, officials said. That device is in testing and in demonstrations currently. But wait, for those of you who've driven in cold climates, what's up? Am I gonna just freeze in the cab of my truck while I'm waiting for the next movement? No. You don't have to run the engine because the electrification kit gives a fuel-fired option to heat the main cabin without idling the entire engine. Don't ask me how it works, I'm not an engineer. One of the Army's big power hogs, the Bradley Infantry Fighting Vehicle, is also about to get its own electrification upgrade. That's according to Defense News reporting on recent budget documents. And also, the Army is looking to go hybrid on that platform to give operators more juice for all the new systems from communications to targeting to reconnaissance assets that the more than 4-decade-old vehicle now has to run. Last up, Army Special Operations have been looking for ways to keep the attack helicopter Little Bird, or the MH-6, flying longer, farther, and faster for more than a decade now. They've been doing that because new helicopters go more than twice the speed of that helicopter. The small helicopter, the Little Bird, kind of made famous by Delta Force in the movie Black Hawk Down, is the only commercial aircraft used by tactical special ops, and it's been upgraded a lot since the 1980s. Engineers are looking at a possible hybrid engine option for the Little Bird, or whatever replaces it, that might allow for the rotor blade change that could reduce drag and speed up the Little Bird. We'll see what they come up with. Reporting from Military Times, this is Todd South.